Hi, this is Angelo from MidiAutomator.com. In this video I will show you how to use Midi Automator if all your songs are stored in one big Ableton Live set. As you can see, we are playing a small gig with only three songs. At the beginning of each song I put a locator. Ableton has the possibility to jump to each locator by learning MIDI messages. MIDI Automator is now able to send a unique MIDI message for each song in a setlist. You just have to configure an appropriate virtual MIDI device. Next, we have to teach Ableton some MIDI messages for the song locators. In the context menu of each song, you can find an option to send its unique MIDI message. So you are able to connect each Ableton locator with a song from your virtual setlist. So now MIDI Automator is able to jump to each song within your Ableton Live set. You can control MIDI Automator via any MIDI controller as explained in the first video. Now you are able to easily change the order of your songs without moving bunches of tracks in Ableton. If you now skip to the next song via MIDI Automator, Ableton's position pointer will jump to the appropriate locator. It is also possible to stop the playback on each song change. MIDI Automator can send a fixed MIDI message whenever the song changes to a configured virtual MIDI device. We just have to teach this MIDI message to the Ableton Stop button. The Send button in the Preferences window will send the message for us. So now the playback is stopped before the pointer jumps to the next locator. The playback will not start playing until you hit the play button, so you can jump silently from song to song and prepare the next tune while the audience honors your performance with applause.